Today, I'm going to be adding some functionality to the Vulkan mini libs, a brand new header that's going to be dealing with the cleanup of Vulkan structs. Now, because Vulkan structs are C-based, there's no like inbuilt RAII capabilities, basically. And they still, a number of them still have pointers to items outside of them, like such as for a lot of the create info, there's like pnext pointers that point to another struct that can also be used. What I want to do is I want to add the ability to clean up these structs on the assumption that the struct owns what it's pointing to. Like if it's being, if the memory is being managed by something else outside, this doesn't apply. But in my case, I want to take the assumption that yes, this struct owns the data it points to. Thus, if I delete this struct, I want to also delete everything that it points to recursively down the line. So, to start with, I'm going to need a new thing. Okay, I'm just going to reuse this since this never went anywhere. Whoops, back up. Actually, do that. So it's VK struct cleanup. Change that up to be struct cleanup. Add a new source file. Underscore. Let's grab some of the basics from, let's say, this one. Should we just need all this? Put this off to the side. The header usage, this is what goes on the top of the header. So it's struct cleanup config. Functions deal with struct points to externally. Okay, we don't need this, the main basic stuff. Okay, we need all this stuff down to the point where we're outputting. This should match. Input, output, checks the file, opens the XML, parses it. The header stuff, header version stuff. Reads in the platforms, time platforms, yeah, okay. I'm just going to basically copy-paste this. Nope. Close up. Okay, let's make sure at least that this builds. Okay, then output starts pretty much the same up to this point. Oh, I need to change the output file, so it's VK struct cleanup. define platform types. Okay. The header, VK struct cleanup. Declarations, and then definitions. Let me finish up. So finishing up, header guard, then declaration. So the declaration is what? It'll be like void VK struct cleanup. Take a void star. It will, because right now I can always go into the S type to figure out what kind of struct it is. Although I'll have to assume that you're passing it a struct that cleans it, that cleans up like that. Yeah. So put that in. Cod star. New line, then we'll have the definition. Portion start, which has the guard. Then we also have at the end when we clean up, or end if. That's new line. Void basically this again. Open new line. What's the basic? So I need like a struct that kind of does. Structure type, I think is what it's called. S type. And then we'll have, what will we have? We'll do that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tab up. How do I do this? I'm going to do like switch between these, right? Ptemp s type with a default case of nothing. And then it's case basis from there. So then we have the bulk of the data, then we'll have the out stuff. Make sure that at least the basics that this outputs correctly. Need a new entry. That's the VK quality check. See what the file it comes out with. And if, like that. Okay, that's better. So at this point, I need to go through on a per struct basis. So I have, structs out of structs. Yeah, I can't use that. It's a reserved name. So any bool has pointer data. Starts up at false. I need to go through each member. I need to see if has, well, pointer member. T dot members. If IT dot name is, what's a good one to have? VK descriptor. Set layout create info sounds good. That has the bindings for set layout bindings. Okay, Just need a quick reminder on how exactly I laid this stuff out. IT members, is it number four? Yeah, bindings. So let's see, the type is properly separated out. Prefix a const, type of star. So I need to see if if mem dot type suffix equals a pointer. Break out of that. If not has pointer data, then we could just continue on. Don't need to be here. Otherwise, we have something we need to add. So we'll just, first of all, need to add the case. IT.name. No. Does this have like the struct type? Ooh. It doesn't. Tab and tab. Okay, let's run that, see what comes out. And it, of course, it'll only delete if the pointers are not null pointer. I probably should have actually put something interesting there. There's a lot of types in here, which have pointer metadata, apparently. It's not great. Okay, let's have a look at the Vulkan doc data, XML data. There may be, like if I'm looking for, let's say, what was it? This. 7, okay. Hmm. could use values equal. Like, is it always? Okay, let's just go to the end. I imagine they're just all that, just that. What's this? H26? Oh, the Vulkan video stuff that they added recently. Okay. In parsing, I can add to. No, not here. Parse XML. Member data. Da, 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 da. Can add that. Let's see where. Struct data. Da, 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 da. Oh. I have some extra debugging stuff in here still. Whoops. If auto value attribute values attribute will be values attribute value. Okay. I don't know what I saved on that. Let's do this again. Let's come on back through. See if we got the struct type information. Iterator members. The first one is struct. We have yes. Okay, we can set that. So it's always going to be if. Actually, let's also do another thing. Let's make sure there's an S type available as well. So don't do that. We can back that up. If it's missing one or the other, but if it's... Then continue. Otherwise, if one of them, then we have a problem. I need to throw an exception. VK structure. Term members, but not a structure. Structure type. That is not something I am accounting for right now. So IT dot, so then, Actually, let's just see if any of that actually holds true. Because if that's the case, then I need to rework the actual base function. Or I'm going to have to, rather than you taking in a void star and then determining, then I'm going to have to do something else. Yeah, okay. VK allocation callbacks as pointer members, but not a VK. Okay, well, let's see how many there are then. Enough. There's enough of them. Reopen the XML and have a look at this. What is this? Put it off to the side. Okay, that kind of makes sense. Okay, this has an S type. Okay, so maybe I can limit it to just those that have structure types. If you have, because P user data is kind of something that would always be done from outside anyways. What about sparse buffer bind info? This may also be in like an external thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. I'm going to limit it to just those who have that type. Okay, then we continue. It's not an error. Yeah. So there'll be that limitation at least. So we've got to go through for auto const and mem out of it.members. Then I need to do this case equals mem dot value. Gets us a little bit closer. That's not good. Some blank cases. Why? What do they belong to? Okay. How many cases are there? Just the two? Okay, then I could just skip those two specific cases because they're very special. Okay, a little bit of a thing with pointer locations. All right. Now we have to go through the pointer members. May also have to. No. We'll leave it like that. PK application info. Then we're gonna go through members again. For auto. Break out. Just plain up deleting things isn't going to work because I need to do a recursive cleanup. But I don't know if it's an actual struct type. I especially don't know if it's like a void star. Well, no, void star pointers we do know will have struct types because it has to have that in order to determine. So we're safe on that. I need some kind of like function. I need some kind of like can cleanup function, which takes in what is this? Some kind of struct data. I need to determine if it's a type that can be cleaned up. So I need to like iterate. I need to take the name. I need to iterate. Okay. If that's the case, then we can call out file. tab. Okay, struct cleanup. Oh, or yes, when I'm inside of here, I need to change it to the type I'm actually working on. So, case, this. Whatever. Equals static cast of constar close up of p data. Yeah, it's not going to fly actually at all. Struct. There we go. This dash in it name, mem dot name. Then we need to delete it. This is probably going to be difficult because it may be like a multiple of them together rather than just one. I may have to change it up so it has to be like malloced rather than new delete and then freed. Maybe. Mem. Okay, so we'll just, first of all, though. Sorry, where are we? Actually, I can also probably change this to a different type as well. That was terrible. Wait, I don't. What? Oh, yes. Although I don't know how it would have gotten past these guys. It's very strange. No. Okay, remove this for the second. Portion here. Okay. Bring this back down. Okay, something I screwed this up somehow. If it has pointer data, and doesn't have a type, not has pointer data, then just skip it. Okay, that makes sense again. We're d back down to just a few. You have this extra stuff. Okay. Can clean up because it has both. Yes, this should work. This part, whoops. Thanks for taking me back there. Okay. Oh, it's still in debug mode. Or it's just broken. Okay, let me just reopen. Oh no, it was just delayed a second. Right? Okay. Oh crap. Well, no, this makes sense. You're only going to run this if you know the struct has the data already. You will add an extra line at the end. Equals can clean up, or I also need to make sure that it's n not null pointer. Or I could just add that to this, really. Because I can malloc or free. Can I? Free or delete on a null pointer does nothing. So I just need to like add a thing like if. At the beginning of the function, if null pointer, then just leave. Oh, I also need a break at the end of these guys. Probably also change this one then as well. Don't really need an extra line though. Looks like it's that recovered. Get rid of the extra new line on that. Actually, no. Have it. That, the cleanups. These are the only types that have pointer members, but not structure types. I don't really... Like, should I actually keep with the switch case, or should I actually split them into separate functions, realistically? Because, well, I'm still going to have to deal with the switch case anyways for, like, pnext. So, yeah, I think I can work with this. I can live with this, I think. So I'll just need to, like, make a test or something, or example. No, I don't really even need that, do I? String parsing error code. Don't really do equality checks. All right, what about generation? Let's do this one. VK struct cleanup. Basically going to do the same thing down here. Let's do that with what's the default? Move them into the root directory. Then we gotta do generate. Well, we start with pretty high level, like 175 or so. That doesn't look right at all. The P stuff makes sense. But like just window in that? That's no. Struggling a little bit. Yeah, oh boy, it's a struggling. What are we doing? Okay, I'm running out of RAM and moving into swap on the laptop. Not great. Okay, let's see if I can close that. Close that. And close that. That should free things up a little bit. And close that. Okay, I'm gonna have to reopen this to get it all into RAM instead of half swap. Okay, we're back here. Parsing, struct cleanup, get rid of that. VK, quality check, that's the old. Okay, going back to what I was looking at, like there were members that were not P pointer things. Like this. Okay, let me take a quick get a quick drink and think this over. Be right back. Okay. Let's look at this. I'm thinking of No. Yeah, what is this? Display star. What is. Like, this looks or sounds like something that would be. These would be all external types. So what I'm thinking is I'm going to do a check. Like, if. Only if it's like a P and then followed by a capitalized letter will I actually delete it. Otherwise, it's most probably something that's external to this and shouldn't be deleted. I mean, if I go into. About this type? P image indices, P results. Yeah, okay. I'm going to go with that idea. So I need to close that up. Do this, move down. That automatically only works on items like that. So I need to do like or I could do a check here. If of member. We're going to continue. Takes in a member data. External. If member data dot name 0 not equals p, lowercase p. Return false if, and then we return true. So not that if, is there like a way to check? If check if okay, close that up. Let's open up that. Okay, language support like maybe like CPP is upper case. Okay, I can do upper and lower case. Okay, if true upper of member na data dot name 1 is if it's not uppercase, yeah. if to lower equals the original, then it means it's lowercase. Yeah. Okay, let's run that one through. Let's add these, or actually, yeah, I add that. Oh, wow. This laptop really cannot handle this. I just wanna. Okay. Okay, so what we got? We got some. Let's go to the Vulkan. Docs, git, checkout, main. Rerun again. Make it match as closely as possible. Still going to be like that, really? Or, oh, it's still. Wow, okay, this is. Oh, pointer. Ooh. No, that makes sense. Don't want to. Probably not do that one. Okay, let's just check if window exists on that one. No. Okay, I think I'm going to just kind of call it good at this point. Otherwise, I'm not entirely. I'm actually going to have to use this somewhere so I can actually figure out if there's any other real large problems in some real world, which I can't quite. Oop, yeah. Okay, struct cleanup. Either that or. Yeah, okay. Unions, struct data. Do I actually use unions? I don't use unions. I don't use platforms either. Add these. Nope. Add these. Yeah. Just generate. In the meantime, I need to add to the get ignore. Vulkan structures are C-based, thus no real memory. Cleanup mechanism. So this, okay, let me just close that, because let's just keep, so. Assumption. The names of P star. See. ignore any means I should probably add this to I need to slightly update this. Close that up. Struct cleanup. Okay, no, we won't do that. What we'll do is we'll just add a bit of So it's already new line again, then this. You know what? Just function comment. Pointed. Is only to be called on have this type. And what? P A to Z. Function doc down here. Okay, we got that. Param. It's version 90. Cute. Okay, don't really care about that. Well, wrong file. All right. Yeah. All right, I'll pause while this is happening. Okay, that's done. Let's have a look at them. Struct cleanup. Looks like all the others. Go back to 90. Gonna have to relook at how far back I go with these, but struct cleanup. Oh crap, I just realized what I'm doing. What if it's a count? Like, what if it's a multi-one? I'm assuming that's always just one. But what if, like, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure if I go back and have a look at this, this is going to be what? It's going to have a count type, right? Do, 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 do. Queue count, queue priorities. Yeah, there may be maybe multiples of the things. Okay, there is a length member I can probably work with. So I'm not done. I am nowhere close to done. So I still probably have what this here. I do have a length and alt length. Sure which one I need to be worried about. So okay, I can still do this. A little bit differently. It's empty, then it's just the one. We can run with it like that. Otherwise, if else, we need to go through, we need to out file. I is less than p struct pointer to m dot length. plus plus I, close it up, next line. I need to do this. No, I close it up, new line. Okay, no, if it's just a single line, then I don't need that either. Let's give that one a go. So I can have that. Rerun it. What's changed? Okay, cool. Nothing's there. Let's clean up all this nonsense. Rerun. So we should have like a for loop somewhere. For space. Missing that for one. Okay. Okay. One too many. For the count. That's about right. CD Vulkan V1.2.176 is the one I believe I'm using. Rerun that. Let's clear out that so I can actually get any other errors. Okay. Okay, I can probably add just a little bit more. So I can add like this. I'm gonna say it's one, two, three. Add some way to like make these a little bit more distinct. Add a new line. Add the new line to that point, get rid of it from the top of here. Yeah, it's one tab too many. One, two, three, four. Okay, and then if, okay, we need a little. New line there, and we need to add like if dot empty. If it's not empty, then we need to add out file space that mem dot length. Then new line on the end, no matter what. P stage to stage count. Nice, 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 nice. This one doesn't have it. Why? Oh, it's probably just not one that requires cleanup. Because it's. Why? Exactly. Or is it just, yeah. Okay, that's not even uint. That's just unt32. Not good. I'm surprised that this was fine with it. I need another space onto that as well. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now we're a lot closer to the end. If it's a multiple, oh, yeah, that may be true as well. We do that. Otherwise, we need to do the other one, which is like an array type. Like that. Neat. Or make them common and free. I don't know. Okay, much better. me just make sure. Documentation for the member. Okay. Let's regenerate. Let's just stick with this, what we have here. Put that in. Clean this up. Actually, can I just delete all HPPs that are in the root directory? They're not useful. Or would that also apply if I'm in like a subdirectory? Hold on. Yeah, no, that's not good. Okay, there we go. Just the root directory now. Maybe? No, because then this one's here. Whatever, I'll just deal with it. All right, I'll call it here unless I figure out something else within the next hour. All right, cheers. Okay, I'm back real fast. So first thing I forgot about is the fact I'm redefining, because this is a switch case, I'm redefining pstruct over and over and over again. And secondarily, I found a bunch of items which really shouldn't be there. So, on one of these. So, gotta, come on, move over. Let's see, make. Turn off and off. Should have actually run that beforehand. So, first things first. This. This is interesting. Semaphore. These should have been added, but they weren't. For whatever reason. Okay, yeah, I see. So this should actually be outside of this. Down here. So that's actually added. Because that's it only runs VK struct cleanup if it's something like be cleaned up. I need to actually have this available whether or not. So if mem.length.empty. To have a separate thing out here, which then else like that. So I'll fix this section up. Oh God, come on, little laptop. Okay, Now we're back on this. Next, pstruct stuff. That is probably going to require... I just need to put everything in a larger scope. One, two, close up, and next line, new line. I'm just gonna put them in blocks. Open up like that. Okay, nope, not that one. It'd have to be added down here. Move that. Case. Okay, here we go. Open up. 1, 2, 3. New tab. New tab. 1, 2, 3, 4. That looks better. This is running on 90 again. Okay. F5 that. Then we'll copy and paste that into here and rerun on the gen. Or just examples, that's what matters here. Put then here, come on. Control V. Configure, generate, run, or build. Standalone. And we've got problems here. Why? Redefinition of pstruct with a different type. Sorry? Is it? Wait, am I reusing like pstruct, the name of something like that? pdata. Okay. No, that's a brand new one in a new scope. Hmm. 79. Previous redefinition here, 170. Like, what? Cannot delete expression with pointer to void type const void star. Oh, this is a warning. Don't care about warnings. No matching call for VK struct cleanup. Do I have to just say it's a void star? No known conversion from that to const void star. Oh, yes, okay. I'm not giving it the address. That makes sense. See, I'm screwing up so many things. Okay, what was the other things? Unknown type this. Okay. So the unknown types is because I must have flags or de definitions hiding around that fixes that for me in the other type. For example, on I'll bet error code or equality checks, probably. Yeah, if it's in the platform type. Okay, so I need to add platform stuff. Let's see. Do I have platform? Okay. What is the specific type I'm missing? VKXCB surface that. Okay, I'm here. I'm in this struct. Like, does this struct have like a plat? This does have a platform. Okay. How do I use platform in quality check? So I'm probably going to have to re-add the platforms. Down here, right? Somewhere, yeah, find the platform. So before I open up the case, if not IT dot platform on empty, I'll just have to do this. And then at the end, platform define. There's always edge cases. Well, not even an edge case. This is like a really obvious case I just completely missed. Okay. Yeah, finish them. Okay. We need to add a new line. new line, meddling with the new lines just a little bit. Looks a bit better. Almost, actually. What's it? What's the difference? These have spaces. This one does not have a space. Is it because I have an extra new line on this? And then I need to add another one onto the end of that instead. Okay, that looks a bit better. Okay, let's try this again. Turn on the examples, which will include that. Wait for that. Or not, just move. Will it compile? With a lot of warnings, yes it will. Okay, let's have a look at this warning. Yeah. Oh my god. I don't want to accept. So it may just be better to just, I'm gonna call free instead. All right. With the stipulation that, I mean, these are just plain old structs anyways. We know what types of structs they are. The only ones that are acceptable are those that, whoops, not delete free. I think we killed that.
Have I just completely forgotten what free is? Or is there like a... Free parking. C++ free parking. Okay. Free. Takes in... Yeah. Standard lib, C standard lib, is that something I need? Is that why? It's a hidden function. Would lose const qualifier. Oh, come on. Okay, const cast. Const. Right. Oh, no. Yeah, void star. Don't even do that, just... Or, no, because it has... No, it has to be the subtype. Star that. Okay. Mem.type. I believe. Turn that off. Rebuild. Rerun. Copy paste. Move back. And forth, over and over again. Oh, that's a mouthful of a struct. Physical device YCBCR 2-plane 444 format features extension. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, it builds now, which is a marked improvement. Using freeze and what have you. Yeah, okay. Okay, now I'm going to
take what now actually finally builds and compiles, and then I'm going to put it into a real project, and then I'm going to see what I need to make improvements on after I get some real-world test data, right? Cheers for real this time.